Well, we are crashing and no one sees it. And do you know where I am filming from? Well, this would be the Titanic, right? Everything was good until it wasn't. And like what I have been telling you for a few days now, get out of the cities. Commercial real estate is selling for 98% off. Yes, Bravo, but cue the fire. We could turn those into homeless shelters. I mean, it is so bad. Even CNN is reporting it's bad. And you don't want to do that, especially with Joey B coming up. And you know 98% of the people over at CNN want this guy to win. And he's actually putting a pretty big foot forward. Biden announces plan to win over younger voters at CNN by getting rid of Blockbuster movie rental late fees. And I say, yes, Mr. President, I am sick of those. As with inflation back up, wah, 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 the long predicted storm clouds in the economy may actually be forming. And that's a lot of bananas. Although I am not a medical professional, I'm just gonna guess that sugar is gonna make you fat. And that's a pretty big insulin spike. Not so much sugar, but stop eating. I mean, that's kind of scientific, right? The less you eat, the more you lose. Did you guys see Cookie Monster? Shows off stunning weight loss. That Ozempic, man, looking good there, Cookie Boy. But CNN comes out with their 3% inflation. Oh my gosh, it's so bad, but it does beat, you know, March's almost 5%. We all know that this is a total lie. Everything that they say is a lie. From the top to the media. I mean, I think Fox is probably close, right? The overall cost of energy up almost 40%. Then fortunately, our government numbers will go, well, we're gonna exclude food and energy, and then everything's pretty good, right? Also talking about inflation, energy, how's that inflation, energy, stagflation trade? We're still good. And honestly, I was a little shocked at seeing, you know, everything going back up again. Inflation, I figured it was done. But the charts were saying it ain't done. See, that's what I love about charts, is they can tell you, they can even predict the news, they can tell you what the news is gonna say just by following it. Tuesday's inflation's numbers, dreadful, almost 37%. And now regular people like you and I, we have to live on that. We have to live, subtract that. Also, let me just pause this for a brief moment to give you some math on why everyone is struggling. Number one, if you get $1 million or $1,000, if you are in the higher tax bracket, which when you own businesses, you are, because they know that you're going to avoid paying them legally. The people that really get shafted would be like a doctor, right? There you go. And you have a truckload of student loan debt. Good luck on that. But just, that's what people tell you to do. 1,000 minus 380, 38% tax bracket. You live in California, 14%. It's right there. Gavin will kick it up there. We're getting there. 13 point something. We're just going to round. You're walking away with $480 just by making $1,000. But you really don't make $1,000, you only make $480. And then you have to go buy said bananas, right? And then pay tax on top of that. And you wonder why so much anger. I know, but then they'll tell you, and then you have inflation, right? That was one of my main points. So they take over half of it in tax, and then the other half they take because of inflation. That's why you have articles like this, quote, "I cannot afford to live. Americans get emotional as the U.S. economy goes off the rails." Oh, but it's not that bad because the stock market went up today. What when that stops? Also, the reason why I just showed you those numbers and inflation, and when I always say you have no choice, every day you have to move money. Thank God that, let's see, I'm thanking God for this one, that we have charts that can tell us which way to go. I mean, trying to move money around with macro, may God be with you. But you have to keep up on prices doubling, like McDonald's. Why this one went viral. Oh my gosh, $25 deal. It's gone up 100% since 2014. Well, no, your money has gone away. Purchasing power, if you had $1 million, right? Well, it's worth half. That is why I bounce up and down every day and say, every day, sorry, you're in a debt-based system. You have to move your digits and you have to get out of the city and you can't be in commercial real estate. Oh, you're in it? Oh, you're a bank that's in it? Look at, and they can only hide it for so long. JP Morgan took a little hit yesterday, huh? right? Even though, you know, their earnings, which is just, it's almost like CP lie, where they'll give you one number that's real low. Like 5 years ago, they'd give you 100. I think we're going to do 100. Now they're like, okay, $1. And then they struggle to even beat the dollar. Now, back to the cities. It's all going. St. Louis downtown trapped in doom loop, marred by empty offices, break-ins, store closing, and this is not going to stop. This will not stop in all cities. San Francisco, gone. And now St. Louis and Beverly Hills. I mean, Beverly Hills is empty. Vidal Sassoon, the whole entire street going down. This is a YouTuber that just, this is what he does. He films what it looks like. I'm going to go with closed, not good, and it's going to continue. From Beverly Hills to San Francisco to Cincinnati? That was a tough one. Hey guys, we'll build back better. Just at some point, everyone's going to pile into these and it's all going to be good. Actually, San Francisco thought of a really good, this is clever guys. Good job, Gavin. Crime-ridden San Francisco seeks to allow lawsuits against grocery stores fleeing the city as mass corporate exodus continues. You can't even leave. And then when you do finally try to leave, they'll still come after you. And then people tell me, oh, it's not that bad. And I say, compared to what? Like, what do you mean? What are you doing? You just inherit like $100 million. I don't know. I mean, it's exhausting for me every day. I have to move money. You think I want to do that? I would much prefer just here. I'll just hold this and it just goes up. No, it's the complete opposite. Everything in my bank account goes down, even though I know it still says 1,000 or 1,000,000, it's actually going down. Because when you then go try to buy that house for 1,000,000, it's now 2,000,000. No matter how hard you're on that hamster wheel trying to save, which that's stupid, you're pedaling backwards. Every day, you and I have to wake up and go, okay, 9 count, swing up. Okay, it's over, can't get above the 200, swing down. That one was actually in my bear market watch list. Under the 200, bear market watch list. Also, you guys keep asking in the comments section, because I did like 1 or 2 days and you're like, please? So this is limited 50% off whichever one that you want. Bull market, stock go up, bear go down, options can go sideways. So 50% off first month if you want to check it out and then we can come move money together. Also for the first time in a couple years, I'm actually cashing out. I'm taking profit on the way up. It's also not that easy to sell physical silver. It takes, you know, normally I like click button, I make money, I click button, I make money. This I actually have to ship things, or you got to go into a coin dealer, which they will rip you off. That would be a whole nother video. Also, silver, Coco, do you think? Are we going to see it? I am going to be selling into this pump. And this is silver futures. Also, for those of you that have asked, you've emailed, I don't like to talk about it until I have a course on it with futures. But it is on my bucket list for this year, so be ready. But please don't do it until first you've mastered the art of the swing. I turned the candles off just so you could still see, like, it's going up. There's confirmation. It's going down. There's confirmation. It's going up. Confirmation. We're now going down below the 200. And also, since it is Thomas Jefferson's birthday, giving you 80% off my swing trading course. Link in the description. Also, happy birthday, Tom. While the government takes your money, more than half, and then they get the rest of it, inflation, we can kind of get them back a little bit. And we do that. Starting businesses, moving money. The economy is sending mixed signals. Really? Think so? About a recession? And that's made the timing of next rate cut less meaningful. This at the same moment that Fed officials are scrambling. They're like, wait, I thought we cooked the books. It's not working out the way we thought. Surging inflation fears since sent markets tumbling. And Fed officials scrambling. As the article says, investors, consumers, policymakers, and economists have been caught off guard with just how stubborn price pressures have been to start 2024. But the energy market sniffed it out and the charts predicted this. You want to know when they predicted this? Watch the line that comes on, the purple one, above the 200, sniffy sniff, That was back, that was in March. Yeah, March, the beginning of March, March 4th. So you had an entire month, and do you see what happens? It goes up, you take profits. That was a crazy swing up. Like with everything, goes up, goes down, goes back up again, goes back down. Also the bank, JP Morgan took a beater. But wait for the reversal. That's going to be a good one. NVIDIA is in a bubble. Stocks will disappoint for 10 years. That's a decade. And recession will strike this year. Markets guru warns. And who is that? That would be Jesse. Jesse Felder. I had him on the show. Smart guy. The market guru said microchip frenzy would fade. Again, all of this. Prepare for slower growth, higher unemployment, sticky inflation. But you're like, look at employment. It's great. Well, what are you counting? Are we looking at full-time? Because if we're looking at full-time, you're spinning your wheels backwards. If you're looking at part-time, we're doing great. It all just depends on how you want to cook the numbers. All right, so what did you learn from the video? The same thing. Get out of the cities, move your money. The government's taking everything. I don't care what city it is, it's all going. And just like Noah, you're given some time to start building the ark. Also, please pay off your credit cards. That's good too. I think that's, but I get it. It's kind of hard to pay off credit cards when everything's eating you. They gaslight you and tell you everything is great. But anywho, it is the weekend. Let's enjoy it. Love you. Thank you for subscribing. And I will see you tomorrow.